everyone, welcome back to our new tutorial. Hope you guys are well. So today in this tutorial I'm going to show you how we can create this amazing interface using HTML and CSS. And here you can see that we have actually a create account interface, and then we have our field, some of our fields, so that we can type our name, email, age, address, number, city, country, school ID, and then we have a button here for submit. And the amazing thing about this form is if we now click any of the field, let's see, if I click on our name field, here you can see that we have a typing option, typing interface, so that we can type our name here in this interface, and it's like a growing up so that we can type. And then if we now click on our email, we have our email section growing up, and then our name section is now shrinked down, and this interface is looking so beautiful. So now let's complete this form, and then for name I will type tag 2 etc. Then for our email it will be tag 2 etc @gmail.com. That's it. And then for our age, we can select our age from here, 26. And then address, we can add any address. And for our number, we can add any number here. Then for our school ID, we can add any number. Then for our country, I'm from Bangladesh. And from city, it can be any city. And guys, this form is completely responsive. It will look good in any kind of device, in our tablet device or in our small screen device. So now let's show you our responsive mode. Now if we shrink our page, here you can see that our fields is actually changing its width and height. And then if we now go to our small screen device, now everything is taking 100% width and height. And this is looking so beautiful. Here you can see that. So here you can see that this page is now completely responsive. And now in a few moments, I will show you how we can create this amazing form using HTML and CSS. And now before we start, I want to show you something. Here YouTube is saying that about 93.4% of my viewers didn't subscribe to my channel, and YouTube might take it negatively. So guys, please, I request you, if you didn't subscribe to my channel yet, then please subscribe, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, you guys can comment below. So that's it guys, let's get started. First, you have to create two files. One is index.html file and another one is style.css file. So now I am in our index.html file, and here you can see that I give a title here. Then we have to link our style sheet, and in our style sheet here you can see that I am using a Google font which is Poppins. And then in our star we have our margin 0, padding 0, box sizing, border box, and our font family. And for our root, it means our global, I am using some global variable, and one is our background color and one is our primary color. And our background color will be black and our primary color will be this color, this green color, I think. Now let's go to our index.html file, and now let's start coding. So here first I will create a main tag, and I will wrap everything inside this main tag. So that's why I create a main tag. That's it. And then I will give a class of this main tag, and it will be container. And inside this main tag, first we have to create a title. So I'm taking h1, and the class of this h1 will be title. And for our h1, it will be create account. That's it. And underneath this h1, now we have to create a div tag, and the class name of this div tag will be row. That's it. And inside this div tag, let's go to our website, and inside our first row div tag, I will put these two, name and the email. So that's why here I have to create another div tag for our name field. So the class name of this field will be input box. That's it. And then here we have to create an input tag, and the type of our input, it will be text, because I will be typing my name, and the name is actually a text format, so that's why type will be name. And then here we have to give an ID, and our ID will be name. That's it. And this field will be required, and underneath this input, now we have to create a label, and let's give a for of this label, and it will be name. That's it. And our label will be also name. That's it guys. Now I will simply copy this one and then paste it here. So our main div class will be input box, and I don't want to change it here, and the type will be mail here. That's it. And our ID and this for name will be also email, and this one will be also email. That's it guys. So our first row is done, which is our name and our email field. Now we have to create our second row, which is age, address and a number. So for adding this one, I will just simply copy this one and paste it here. That's it. So our main div class will be row, and here you can see that we have two div, two input format, but here in our second row we have three actually. So I will just copy another one and then paste it here. So our first one will be here. You can see that our age. So this will be age. That's it. And the age is actually a number. So that's why type will be number. And our ID and our 4 will be also age. That's it. And our second one will be actually address. So it will be address. And our ID and our 4 will be also address. And our type will be text here. That's it. Then other one is number. So it will be number. And our 4 and ID will be also number. So our type will be text here. That's it. So after this section, now we have to copy this one again and paste it here. And this row is actually for our third row here, school ID, country and city. So let's go to our index.html file. And here it will be school ID. That's it. And our age and our 4 will be also school ID. That's it. And the type will be text here. Our second one is our country. So it will be country. And our address and our 4 will be also country. So our type will be text. And then we have our city here. After country, we have our city. So that's why it will be city. Then our ID and the 4 will be also city. And our type will be text. Our HTML file is now done. Now let's save this file and then go to our website. And then now refresh. So here you can see that we have our name field, email, age, address, number, school ID, country and city. All of the fields here. Now it's now looking so boring. Now we have to style this page so that it look like this one. So for styling this page, now let's go to our style sheet. Oh, okay, we forgot one thing. We didn't put our submit button. This button, we have to create this button also. So for creating our button, I'll just copy this from here and then paste it here. Delete these things. And here we have to create a button tag and it will be submit. Let's say now save, go to our website and now refresh. Here you can see that now we have our submit button. Now let's style this page. So for styling this page, now let's go to our style sheet. And then first we have to target our body. And for our body, here you can see that now everything is actually in the top right. But I want everything to be in the center here, in the center position of our screen. So that's why I will create display. And the display will be flex. And our flex direction will be column. Justify control will be center and the align items will be also center. Then I will give a height and a mean height will be 100 VH. That's it. Then I have to set our background color. Currently our background color is white, but now I will give a background color. And our background color will be var, our global variable, which is bg color. So copy this line from here and then paste it here. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Okay, now everything is now in center and we have our background color. But something is missing here. So for now, let's go to our index.html file and from here copy this container class and then go to our style sheet and then paste it here. That's it. Now I will create a flags group and it will be 3. Then I have to give a display and the display will be flags. Flags direction will be column. Justify content will be center and the width. Now I have to give a width. So our width will be 80%. That's it. And then I have to give a padding here. So padding will be 20 pixels. Then I have to give a gap here and our gap will be 40 pixels. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Here you can see that now we have our paddings here. Now let's go to our style sheet again. Now we have to go to our index.html file and from here we have to copy our title. So copy this title and then paste it here. So first we have to give a font size and our font size will be, let's say, 40 pixels. And the text align will be center because I want to align this center. And user select will be none. Then we have to give a color and our color will be var. This color, one from here. And then paste it here. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Here you can see that now we have our text, our title, and we have changed our color here. So after this title, now we have to target our row class. So copy this row class from here and then paste it here. That's it. So for making our page responsive, I will use grid system. So that's why I create our display grid. That's it. And then grid template columns. Then we have to give some properties here. So I will give repeat. And here we have to give two parameters. So first one will be auto fit. So our second one will be a function and it will be actually min max. That's it. It's a function. And inside this function, we have to give two value. So first one will be the minimum value, because whenever I will sync our website or whenever I will go to our mobile screen device, I want to take a specific amount of width of every part of every field. So this field will take the minimum width in our small screen device. So our minimum value will be 200 pixels. That's it. And I want to take this one full frame. So that's why it will be 1 FR. That's it. Then we have to give a gap here. So our gap will be also 40 pixels. That's it. So after this row, now we have to go to our index.html file and then copy this input box from here and then paste it here. That's it. So first I'll give a position, and position will be relative. Then we have to give our display, and the display will be flex. Then we have to give our flex direction, and it will be column, river, not column. Then I have to give a height, and our height will be 40 pixels. Let's see, now save, go to our website and now refresh. So now here you can see that everything is now in center. And then we have our first row, second row and third row. So this is our submit button. Now it's looking awkward, but I will fix this later. So now copy this class from here and then paste it here again. Now we have to target our label. So copy this tag and then paste it here. That's it. So for our label, it will be position relative. Then we have to give a top value. So top will be 0. Then left will be 10 pixel. That's it. Let's give a font size, and our font size will be 10 pixel. 20 pixel. And then I have to give a color here. So I'll just copy this color from here. That's it. And then paste it here. Then I have to give a transition. So our transition will be 0.5 second. Then cursor will be text here. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. So now we can see our label here. And here you can see that we have 10 pixel padding from our left side. So after this one, copy this one again and then paste it here. Then go to our index.html file, and from here we have to copy this input and then paste it here. So first I will give a position. Position will be absolute, obviously. Then we have to give a background color. Background color will be which one? This one. So copy and then paste it here. Then I will give a width, and it will be 100%. Then we have to give a height also, and the height will be now 4 pixels. That's it. And the bottom will be 0. And the box shadow will be none. Then we have to give our border. Border will be also none. And the outline will be also none. Now we have to give a border radius. And the border radius will be 2 pixels. That's it. Then we have to give a transition. And the transition will be 0.5 seconds. Then we have to give a font size. And our font size will be 20 pixels. Then font width. So font width will be bold. Then padding. Padding will be 0 from top and bottom, and 10 pixels from left and right. Now save and go to our website and now refresh. Here you can see that we have width of 4 pixels of our this underline. I mean the input section. So after this one, now we have to create the magical effect. So this effect I am talking about. So we have to create this magical effect. So for creating this magical effect here, first we have to do one thing. Copy this line from here and then paste it here. And here first we have to create our focus. That's it. Then again we have to paste it, and then it will be valid. And here we have to give our height 100%. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Now if we click here, you can see that we can see our this magical effect, but this magical effect is not actually properly working. So we have to make this working. So for doing this, we have to copy this one and then paste it here. And here we have to add something. So for adding, it will be plus, and then it will be level. That's it, guys. And for our level, whenever I will click on this field, I want this name text to be a little bit on the top side. So for doing this, we have to give a top here, and the top will be minus 40 pixel. That's it. And for our left, it will be 0. Now let's go to our website and now refresh. Now let's click. Now everything is looking magical. So yeah, now it's working. So after this one, now we have to target our button. We have to fix this button also. So for fixing this button, we have to go to our main here. So copy this container class from here and then paste it here. That's it. And then we have to target our button. So first thing, we have to give a width. So width will be 200 pixels. Then we have to give a height also, and the height will be 50 pixel. Then we have to give a border, and a border will be none. Then we have to give outline, and outline will be also none. Then we have to give a cursor, and it will be pointer. Then we have to give a background color, and the background color will be our primary color, which is this one. So copy this one from here, and then paste it here. Then we have to give a font size, and our font size will be 20 pixel. Then I have to give a font width, and it will be bold. Then we have to give a border radius, and our border radius will be 2 pixel. That's it. Now save, go to our website, and now refresh. So border radius will be 2 pixel, not 20. Now refresh. We have a submit button, but I want this submit button in the center. So that's why here it will be justify self, not center, and it will be center. Let's see. Now save, go to our website, and now refresh. Here you can see that now our button is now center, and now everything is now looking good. So now let's see it's working or not. Okay, this field is working, this one is also working, and for our age also working, address working, number working, city working, country working, and then school ID also working. So now let's see it's actually responsive or not. So if we now sync our website, here you can see that our input fields is now changing the width and height. Now if you go to the small screen, here you can see that everyone changing the width and height, and it's now looking good here. So I think that's it guys. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you guys really enjoyed this tutorial, then please press subscribe, like this video, and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, you guys can comment below. That's it guys. Let's see you in our next tutorial.